Find yourself in the Beachview area of Pittsburgh? Check out the official pizza of this show, Slice on Broadway, sharing an abnormal obsession with pizza we can relate to. Check them out at sliceonbroadway.com and tell them this show sent you.
I'm hungry, spark, but I ain't starving yet. Chain for the pain, cocktail bar set. Never said I was a gangster or thug, but I'm an animal. Peanut for the taste of the poor.
Hey guys, it's Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitters here in the Mayhem Studios in Pittsburgh, PA for your Indie Mayhem Show episode 81. We got a great interview coming up. I am the producer of some wrestling here in the Pittsburgh area, the IWC, the RWA, over at PittsburghWrestling.com, the upcoming IndieWrestling.us. With me, my compatriot in Indie Wrestling, he is the voice of Inspire Pro Wrestling down there in Texas, coming at us today from Corpus Christi, where they like to throw things in the golf at the WWE shows, as we discussed the last show. He's aiming pain at aiming to please on the tweeters.
Yes, Zorg. That's the one defining thing about Corpus Christi, Texas, the only thing. But yeah, I'm very excited to be here and very excited to talk about indie wrestling once again.
What else is there? And of course, this is your Indie Mayhem show. We'd like to talk to about indie wrestling in general. Our little corner, we got to talk about this thing with the people that also dig it too. So you can check us out at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. This and so many other shows on video and audio format. Subscribe to us, comment, rate us, whatever you can do. And please just share it with everybody if you're digging what we're doing around here. And let us know, hey, if there's anybody you think we should be talking to, if you have questions for anybody that we've announced coming up on the show, you can drop a line to 412-206-WMS0 for the hotline or the email address at goodtimes@wrestlingmayhemshow.com, like it says on the t-shirt. Please check out our friend Basic Sickness at basicsickness.com. Pittsburgh Original doing the intro and outro music for this. And check out our Patreon for the Wrestling Mayhem Show in general. If you dig everything, become our boss. Donate a little bit a week at patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. Eamon, we got another guest for this week on the phone. Who are we talking to, buddy?
We're talking to someone who I've wanted to have on the show for a good while now, somebody who is making waves across the Texas independent wrestling scene for very good reason. He is, I know, the current Lone Star Junior Heavyweight Champion for Lone Star Championship Wrestling. He's also the current NWA Wrestling Revolution Grand Warrior Champion, and is doing many great stuff across Texas. Joining us this week is the one and only Cherry Ramons. Cherry, how are you this evening?
Hey, how's it going, guys? Pretty good, pretty good. How've y'all been?
Great. Definitely great awesome. Having you on again, as mentioned. Kind of the way we start off the show is with sort of an icebreaker question in a sense, to see how people sort of first got into professional wrestling. What's your first ever memory of watching professional wrestling?
Oh, man, to be honest with you, the first memory I have is me being being a small little kid. My dad had me on his lap, and I just remember watching Hulk Hogan versus Andre the Giant. That's like my first ever memory of wrestling that I actually have. I was a small little kid. I want to say probably like about four or 5 years old, maybe even younger, but that's like the first memory that I have is actually watching that match at WrestleMania, watching that WrestleMania 3 match with my dad on his lap.
Awesome. Very cool. Definitely a great way to get into it. Did you have any, at one point in your life, did you start having thoughts of wanting to become a professional wrestler and transition into that life?
Actually, when I was, the same thing, like going back to when I was young, one of the matches that actually made me want to become like a wrestler is actually watching Mankind for some reason. I remember watching Mankind. I'm like, dude, this guy is so awesome. I love him. He's a bomb. He can take a hit. One of the matches that I loved watching him in was the Boiler Room Brawl. Watching that match and then watching Shawn Michaels and Razor Ramon. That one really, watching them really got me going. I really want to do this. And then, man, there was like so many other matches, and so many other guys, like Chris Benoit and the Eddie Guerrero. Watching them just made me want to, do this.
Awesome. Definitely. Very cool. And where exactly did you get your start in wrestling, and how long ago did you first sort of go to wrestling school and start your training?
When I first started, I actually skipped what's called my senior prom to do my first ever training. Oh, wow. I started off with what was called Lucha Libre. I got taught the basics on that. You know, with like the bumps. You know, those rolls. Pretty much the way how every wrestler gets trained is like all the bumps and rolls. You know, and with Lucha Libre, it's almost the exact same thing, but they mainly focus on the actual rolls. From there, in 2004. Bruce Tharp actually gave me my first ever break. He's the one that actually put me on a live recorded show that was going to be shown on TV. And I was just so nervous about that. And, the first show that I ever did, it was me and the other guy's name was Johnny Rage against Dante and Alan Taylor, I believe, you know, a guy from Bronzeville, had that match, and I was so nervous, you know, like, of course, like, you know, and even to, like, this day, I still get nervous, but that was, like, my first ever actual break into, like, doing American-style wrestling. That was back in November of 2004.
So you've been getting at this for a good while now, and I know rising up the ranks, especially in the local wrestling scene. I also want to mention, because this is something I think some people know, but not everyone knows about you, is I know especially you went through a great period of some really big weight loss as well. You obviously in phenomenal shape right now. What was it like, sort of that transition of getting into the shape that you are now?
Oh man, it was something different, because honestly, I didn't start traveling outside of the Rio Grande Valley until like about 3 years ago, and it was until like about those 3 years ago where I started to to lose weight. When I started to like actually venture off outside of the Rio Grande Valley, I would see like all these guys, you know, they were like really fit, they were like big guys. You know, and that actually motivated me to like wanting to like actually lose weight, you know, because like ever since I actually lost the weight and did all that stuff, my bookings like shot straight up, like way up there, you know. So I was like, whoa, like this is crazy. Like I've never received so many emails, messages, calls, and text messages and stuff like that, you know, for like shows. I'm like, wow, this is really awesome. And, you know, and it's such a true blessing to actually go through that, to be honest with you. It was really like it's a mental thing when it comes to like this whole weight loss, you know, for myself.
Definitely. And would you know specifically like how much weight you did lose in the process and where you're at now currently?
Oh yeah. Okay. Well, when I first started, I was at 275 pounds. I was really big and round. And right now I'm actually at 208 pounds.
Nice.
But yeah, man, it's been such a crazy journey with this whole weight loss, and you know, it's been really awesome, to be honest with you. I can't really lie about that. It's a really great feeling.
No, that's awesome, definitely, and I think it shows a lot of great, you know, determination in that sense to put that work in, and like you said, it definitely did show in like you said, like the bookings you get and stuff like that. Really, really great stuff to see. I also want to mention another. We're also talking physical features in a sense. One thing I think a lot of people who have seen you at a wrestling show know you for is your posterior. I guess is the best way to put it. You have a certain talent, I guess, even beyond your wrestling talent, of working your posterior in a sense. What has that been like? And have you gotten a lot of fanfare from that aspect of your game as well?
Yes. I actually do shake my booty. I can dance, twerk, do that stuff. And I kind of do incorporate that into my whole wrestling. And yes, actually, it has. I've actually gained like a lot of fans because of that, and it's really weird. And like you know, I don't know, very awkward questions. Can I touch your butt? I'm like, what? Like, how about just my autograph, and that's it.
I think for me, like the biggest shocker for me was, I think it was at Fun Fest last year. After our event was done, and I just turned around and there's a line of women like lined up to get pictures with you, because of your performance.
Yeah.
But definitely, oh, awesome. Man. Like you said, you've been doing this for a good while now. What are some of the matches that you've had that kind of stick out to you as ones that you've learned a lot from, or just matches that you hold as really special to you that you've had?
Oh man, that was a really good question. There are so many matches and people that I have actually worked with that really hold close to me, and people that I've worked with have really changed the way how I actually work as well, with like the whole psychology side of what's called wrestling. Oh man, you caught me in a really good spot right there. Oh wow. Wow, I'm actually blank on that one bit, but
well, I know also, I guess maybe we can tie that in a sense, but I know one of your main companies that you work for is a Wrestling Revolution down in McAllen. And I know you're sort of a big part of that organization there. What has it been like? Because I believe we had Eric Shadows on once before to sort of talk about that promotion as well. What's it like working down there in the McAllen area?
Oh man, like honestly, dude, I love it down here. You know, this is a place that I actually call home. You know, like this will always be my home, no matter what. Like even if I move to like another city, state, country, you know, like this will always be my home. You know, and like the crowd down here, it's they're very lucha, what's called base. You know, like they love the whole entertainment aspect of it. Mm-hmm. Like characters is always like a really, really big thing down here. And that's where I guess that's where my, like my whole character and like my whole persona, you know, developed. It was actually here. Like everything has been, you know, because of like Wrestling Revolution.
Definitely, yeah. And actually, I remember I got to visit a show for you guys not too long ago, and I remember being really, really surprised in a great way by that crowd, because you could tell, like, it was a lot of regulars, but it was a lot of regulars that really followed, like, the company and like, the intricacies of everything. And it was a really awesome environment. It seems like there's some really good stuff going on down there.
Oh yeah, man! Like we have some really hard devoted fans. A lot of them follow the whole entire storyline. They get really they really invest in our persona. Like they really get into it down here.
Awesome, definitely. Going to some of our regular questions here on the show. One that we've been asking a lot of the people on here. What are you watching currently when it comes to wrestling? Is there anything that you're sort of studying or just watching for, you know, recreation purposes? Is there anything in particular that you kind of have your eye on?
Nothing really in particular. I usually watch everything. You know, like I watch everything. I watch, WWE, New Japan, a lot of independent wrestling companies. I do watch a lot of the old NWA stuff. I don't really have an actual set thing that like I actually watch. You know, I watch everything, and I usually study a lot of the stuff. You know, because with me, I like to pick up a lot of things, as you know. I like to pick up as much as possible. Like the way how I say it, if you only study one certain thing, you know, I don't think that your mind will actually grow from there. You know, if you study a lot of different things, your mind will expand. Your mind will actually grow. You'll absorb a lot of the stuff, and you can really incorporate all those styles and all those things that you see into your matches.
Definitely. Absolutely. And also going into another one of our big questions, and the guests on our show take it in many different ways, so feel free to take it any which way you wish. But the question we have is what, in your opinion, is the best thing about independent wrestling and the worst thing about independent wrestling?
Honestly, man, one of the coolest things about independent wrestling is that you can do anything and everything and get away with it. there's so many things, to be honest with you, man. There's just so much good to talk about. There is, some bad as well. Man, you got me into another good question.
Everybody don't want to know, And like I said, people kind of take it in many different ways. So don't feel like you need to, choose.
There's a lot of good stuff in the whole independent wrestling scene. There's a lot of great stuff, and how I said, you can do a lot of things and get away with it,
Definitely.
Yeah, for example, my whole booty shaking. I don't think some of these big companies out there will actually allow me to actually do some of the stuff that I have, where I have a guy on the old corner throw my whole entire back and kind of grind on him to insult him, and then come back and hit him with a freaking stiff elbow or a stiff Yakuza kick. Yeah, man, there's a lot of great stuff with the whole indie scene, a lot of great stuff.
Awesome. Definitely. And I can definitely see that. And kind of like you mentioned, you get more control of your character and what you get to do in that aspect.
Exactly. You pretty much have the freedom to do whatever you like. Do almost, a lot of the, you can portray anything and everything. I guess it also depends on the there are some family friendly companies out there, there's certain amount of things that you can actually do. Me myself, I've never really been a big fan of the whole cussing, to be quite honest with you. I've never really been a huge fan of that. A lot of the people, say it. It gets, a really good reaction, but there is a time and place for that.
Definitely, yeah.
No,
definitely. And you seem like a guy that's able to work sort of more. But I mean, even with the stuff you do, it works in a more family friendly environment. And in that case, kind of makes you more versatile in a sense, the way you can work a lot of different places.
Yes, exactly.
Definitely. So thank you very much, Cherry, for coming on and talking with us. If people want to find you on the internet, or if you have any upcoming shows that you'll be appearing on, feel free to plug away.
Yeah, man. Every Friday I am down here at the NWA Wrestling Revolution every single Friday. This coming Sunday I will be at Inspire Pro, and you can find me on Instagram as well. At the_juicy_1, and yes, you spell it 1-O-N-E. And for my Facebook, it's facebook.com/deadshadow04, and that's actually that deadshadow04 is my what's called PSN, my PlayStation Network.
Oh, nice.
gamer tag. I love video games too. I'm sorry.
No, definitely awesome. Definitely. So maybe people can follow you hopefully on there as well. Like I said, thank you very much, Jared, for joining us here on the Indie Mayhem Show. And right now we're going to dive into some of the stuff that happened this week in Sorgatron Media.
Also, this is also very important because I have Chachi on the show. If you go to the website for Chubby Shorts on the bright bottom right-hand side, mm-hmm. It says...
Sheriff, you hate pants.
Yes.
That's amazing.
So they're just
let me go do that right now.
Yeah, you're like, I love these people. We are best friends. I mean, it's this very human aspect and very. I just really like their product, and like I said, their short videos.
Why would they possibly listen to John Cena? He's only been the top guy in the company for a damn decade, Sorg.
Because they don't give creative control. Because
why
they don't
you,
give creative control in their
me?
Contracts
why
anymore.
Talk to the man. Talk to the man over there.
I can't even.
He feels Sorg. He can't reason with. They don't give creative control in their contracts anymore. Not since. Racist Hulk Hogan in WCW ran that to the ground.
Right back around.
Chachi Plays for Kids is coming back again, the 24-hour game-a-thon for youth arts programs in Pittsburgh. August 7th and 8th at the Toonzeum, or join us live at ChachiPlays.com. Find out how you can make a difference to and donate today. ChachiPlays.com.
Up, down, down, left, right, B-A, start!
Yeah! Go check out that so much more at SorgatronMedia.com. Hey, Eamon, there was a wrestling show this weekend. My first one for a while with the IWC. So it was Proving Grounds, a smaller show, you know, where they do a few different venues, and then this is at White Oak. You know, we don't have the big setup or anything, thankfully, which reminds me, I have a lot of stuff I need to fix before we do that setup again. Holy crap. But anyways, it was a fun show. Usually Proving Grounds has a lot of new faces pop up. We only had a couple coming out of the training academy, and we had a tag team called the Fraternity, very classic tag team. They kept yelling Fraternity Eternity, so that was pretty interesting. You were there. I talked about Space Monkey, and I know you have not.
Oh, Space Monkey!
Seen the Space Monkey. Wheels in the chat room says he worked with Space Monkey over the weekend as well. But generally it was a very fun show. I don't know what it is that IWC does different than everybody else. And I don't know if it's just my familiarity with the product or something, but there's just not a lot of filler, it feels like, when I watch these shows or when I'm helping to produce these shows. It feels like everything has a place. And I think that's something that I don't see a lot as much. Now, anything else. RWA, I thought, had a really good flow to their last show, too, with Resurrection, which is something which I can talk a little bit about that, too, because I did get to edit that over the last weekend. I'm showing here a little bit of the Space Monkey and Chest Flex, or this was a little later in the show. It was a fun match, like just an absolutely fun match, entertaining. I got a kick out of that the entire time. Great match at the end, Bill Collier versus Jimmy Nuts. Just Nuts getting destroyed. At one point, Nuts got picked up and thrown into the crowd, like kind of Spike Dudley style. And this isn't the first time they've done it at this venue. I should just kind of get used to it by now, but at least I did have a second camera this time. Just good stuff. And we'll have her, we've done some rescheduling, but we should have next week Britt Baker, who debuted, the first lady wrestler to come out of their school in a while, at the very least. She had a very fun, match with, Andrew Palace, mixed tag with Andrew Palace, Dylan Bostic, and Reagan Lynn. Dude, there's a women's division now of a sort here with IWC. Yeah. I'm thinking we're going to run into them having a one-on-one match very soon as well. I'm excited for that. You know how I get about women's wrestling, especially in the area. It doesn't feel like there's enough of it. And if there's, you know, one more chance that this could be, you know, happening somewhere else, sure, that's amazing. It's still in a little bit of a development right now. We don't have commentary on it just yet, since Joe Dombrowski was too busy selling the Virgil DVD down south. But all together, very fun show, very fun time. And I actually have, as kind of side comments, I talked a little bit about IWC actually on Basic Sorgonomics, where I'm talking about social media state of minds. You can check that out at sorgatron.com. We've talked about this before, but Dan Hooven is still freaking killing it on Instagram.
Oh yes, we have. Me and Sorg have had long conversations about, a lot of conversations about the stuff that's going on for IWC on the Instagram.
He's using something that's very rudimentary, but it shows when you have somebody involved that knows what they're doing, whether it be, you know, well, there's a picture right there of that. You know, I mean, he's got great photos to begin with, fantastic photographer, but he's going in and doing these text overlays on these things. You can check him out, Instagram.com/IWC_wrestling, and just doing these great promo shots with these guys. And, you know, using hashtags, using some of their phrases, and just creating some tremendous, and this is so important because these are things that then get shared by the wrestlers themselves, by fans, etc. I mean, most of these have like 20 to 30 to 40 likes here on Instagram. They're definitely creating a buzz visually, and it helps bridge that gap between shows, I think, right?
Definitely.
And tells that story, and I think that's something very, very cool. The other thing that happened, and I talked about this actually on the Power Hour. You can check out the LB and the Sword morning and afternoon Power Hour episode 13, also over at Sorgatron.com. But I got into a little bit of the Virgil DVD, which released this week. Very cool to see that in the hands of Jim Cornette and Gerald Briscoe, of all people. This past weekend, Joe Dabrowski again went down to the NWA Fan Fest. I'm getting all kinds of reports back from that. It's out there. It's out in the wild. If you've watched it, are you going to watch it? I'd love to hear what you guys think of it. Eamon, I'd love to hear your thoughts on it if you get a chance to watch it here. So I mean, it's
something different.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and I think it's something that, I mean, you know, there's shoot interviews and stuff like that, but I think there's something, it's a topic that hasn't really been covered,
mm-hmm.
you know, and it's a big topic.
Right. Cause I mean, Virgil is this interesting meme, right? And this fits on the Indy Mayhem show because he's the guy that pops up on an indie wrestling like all the time, you know, spend an afternoon in his living room recording this and having an interesting time there. You can check out joe-dabrowski.com or over at pittsburghwrestling.com and the upcoming indiewrestling.us. But I got a little deeper into it and my thoughts on Virgil and, you know, kind of that position and everything. And there's just a lot. There is a lot of weirdness around him. Yes, certainly. But I think in the long run, he's going to be just fine. And if those don't know, he's been around doing AMAs, Ask Me Anythings on Reddit. He's actually involved with getting help on Twitter from the guys that do the Iron Sheik's documentary on Twitter. So, I mean, they're really kind of pushing him as a meme. And I'm really hoping, if nothing else, this will be entertaining. And I think this will, in the long run, help him to a certain point, and really kind of expand that meme, right? Because he kind of fell into it to begin with, that there's this whole thing happening around him showing up with his table all over the place, and it became this thing. And I've talked with the guy. He has no idea. He does not know how popular he is, you know, in this other way. Let alone, I really don't think he understands the internet at all. I explained to him a piece about Twitter, and he just looked at me, right? And then I found out he was on Twitter, and I'm like, oh, God, is that my fault? No. Somebody came to him. But still, it's very entertaining. It was a lot of fun. I'm glad it's out there, and hopefully you guys are really enjoying that as well. So what's going on with you? I know you got some Inspire Wrestling going on down your way.
Definitely, we got a big event coming up this weekend, that being our big Fade to Black event, which I am very excited about. I think this may be one of our more stacked cards that we've had for Inspire Pro. Some really cool stuff happening there. That's this Sunday, August 9th. If you are in or around Austin, Texas, I definitely encourage you to come down for that because it's going to be a really fun time. The main event being Andy Dalton defending his Inspire Pro Championship against Absolute Ricky Starks, which should be a phenomenal contest. Those two faced off in Inspire Pro, I would say, probably about a year and a half ago, and it was an amazing encounter. So I definitely expect them to top it this time around. We also got some pretty big matches in two friends of the show as well, Angelus Lane, taking on Keith Lee for the Pure Prestige title. Intergender wrestling purists will probably, naysayers, I should say, will probably hate this match. But you know what? We're doing it anyways. And it's a bit of a match that a lot of our fans have demanded. So we're very excited to put it on. And I think it'll be really interesting and really cool. If that hasn't sold you, we have a triple threat match that was originally supposed to be a singles match. Now is a triple threat with Barbie Hayden and Kimberly and Athena, which has, if you know any of those three athletes, it has all the makings to be a show stealing night, a show stealing match, I should say. Definitely, it's a really great lineup with a lot of talented people. I'm so very excited for the show coming up. And like I said, that's August 9th at the Marquesa Hall and Theater in downtown Austin, Texas. Front row tickets are sold out, but you can still get general admission at inspireprowrestling.com. Those are only $15. So definitely go to that, or if you're going to be around that area on September 13th, that's when we're doing Battle Wars 2, our joint show with Chikara Pro Wrestling, the stars of Chikara Pro Wrestling. And I've heard some rumors of some people that may be coming down. I think hopefully, I'm not positive on this, but we may be announcing some of those names on Sunday. And yeah, I'm very excited. Last year's Battle Wars was one of my greatest moments being in wrestling. And I feel like this year we definitely have the potential to top it. So definitely go check that out. And I think Front Row is just about sold out for that show. Nice. So definitely go get your tickets now at inspireprowrestling.com.
Good stuff. Good stuff. That's all I got. I mean, just kind of indie wrestling's good right now, man.
It's pretty good right now. Yeah. I mean, in general, it's pretty good. Honestly, I think it's pretty good right now. September will be an interesting month, I think, for Texas.
Mm-hmm.
I will say, because we've got the Inspire show, obviously. We've got two Ring of Honor shows in one weekend. We've got three NXT shows in one weekend. There's a bunch of really cool other indie shows that will be happening. September will be a really good month to be a Texas wrestling fan, I feel.
We do have a comment from the chat room from Alex Cars out there in Cali. He says, why has Space Monkey not been in Chikara yet? These are questions that keep me awake at night.
Oh, one last thing I will mention, I guess. I kind of went on about it on the Wrestling Mayhem show and part of our big question. Mm-hmm. But Journey into Chikara, which is Chikara's new weekly show, on their YouTube channel and on Chikaratopia, their streaming service. Really phenomenal stuff. I'm not just saying that because I've worked with some of the guys. This is really great stuff. They're doing it for 6 weeks as sort of an experiment. They're basically testing it out in a sense and seeing if people like it and if they should do it more often. I want them to do it more often because it is so good. I encourage you to watch it. It's on Wednesdays. It airs originally on Wednesdays at 7 Eastern, 6 Central on their YouTube channel and on Chikaratopia, but they also play some replays throughout the week. Mm-hmm. Go watch it because it is so fun and really, really great stuff. Production value is great. And I think Sorg, you would really love it in particular because it's that perfect mix of like the Saturday morning. It's Saturday morning wrestling, but on a Wednesday night. It's really fantastic.
Am I seeing it only streams live? They don't actually have it up for posts, or it like probably under their.
They don't have it up for posts, but they do replay it a couple times throughout the week.
That's interesting.
As a live thing, they don't keep it up for posts though. No.
All right.
It is like a kind of a wrestling show in a sense.
Right. It's just weird. It's a weird decision to do these days when everything's on demand. Right.
That's true. Like, yeah.
So, but still, I see what they're doing.
I have to check and see, but I believe if you get their streaming service, you can watch it.
Right. Right. That makes sense. That's a good reason to try to get people in there. But if you're just like, I'm always busy Wednesday, you know, it just kind of, you lose that chunk. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I don't know. And plus there is so much going on already on Wednesday night. So
I think one of the replays actually is on Saturday morning, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, that'd be great.
So that is kind of
Cheerios, man.
Yeah.
All right.
Get your Cheerios and watch some Chikara.
Awesome. Thanks so much for our guest this week, Cherry Ramon. Some great conversation there. Anyway, I never thought about that. Just like training Lucha Libre right off the bat.
Mm-hmm. So. Definitely. I mean, and definitely like that kind of, because that's the kind of Southern Texas sort of, you know, that's what it's kind of brought up on is the Lucha style.
Mm-hmm.
So it's definitely cool to get like that kind of perspective on it.
Awesome. Awesome. So go check him out. Follow him on the PlayStation Network. And please follow everything else going on at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Subscribe to this and other shows, as well as 412-206-WMS0. Good times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Right, it is right there. Check it out, ProWrestlingTees.com/WMS, and everybody else that's on there as well. Eamon, he's at Eamon2Please, InspireProWrestling.com.
Yes, indeed. I also at InspireProRes on Twitter.
There you go.
And Eamon2Please on Twitter.
And I'm at SorgatronMedia.com, Sorgatron.com, PittsburghWrestling.com. Check out our friends over there. And we'll see you guys next week. Support indie wrestling. Never said I was a gangster or thug, but I'm an animal. Beat up for the taste of the poor. Sick, 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 you know how I act now. If you got a problem, come and see if I'm a back down. Joe is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.
Hi, everyone. Do you like video games? Do you like reading about video games? Do you like listening to podcasts about video games? Why don't you check out insertcointobegin.com? New articles going up daily, and you can check out our podcast, Boss Battle, on sorgatronmedia.com.